Victory is supported by Chandler Lodge 227 of the Free and Accepted Order of Masons.
Welcome to Victory on BCTV. Be informed, be involved. Hi, I'm Tom Frank, your Victory host tonight. And tonight we have the American Red Cross, that is the Berks County chapter, because this being the month of March, March is Red Cross Month. And we're here to really show you, the home viewer, what the Berks County chapter is really all about, what they can offer you within our community, but more importantly, what you can do for the Red Cross. So let's find out who we have with us tonight in Studio A from the Berks County chapter of the American Red Cross. Welcome.
Welcome. Thanks, Tom.
And tell us about what your duties are, of what you might have to do at the chapter house when someone calls in with any kind of information question. Do you take those questions directly, or do they just get fielded to perhaps the call box?
They get fielded to different departments. It depends what the caller is calling about. I like to answer as many as I can. I am Janet Curtis. I'm the executive director of the Berks County chapter.
Great.
And I love to talk to people about the American Red Cross and the experience that we can offer you as a potential volunteer or donor or whatever else you may want to be involved in.
Absolutely. And let's go to our next mystery guest.
Hi, I'm Kara Mowbray, and I am the Emergency Services Director. And actually, we cover, as a region, 16 counties, actually. So right now, 16 counties with 4 emergency services.
So the Red Cross has kind of restructured over the couple of years in the past. But more importantly, we have with us tonight both Kara and Janet, who are here really to take your questions or comments. If you have any, please call in. We're here live in the studio. You can certainly call the number that will appear on your screen. It's 610-378-0426. We'd be happy to take your questions or comments at any time during the broadcast. So please, let us hear from you and what we can do for you. Let's talk about the Red Cross month of March. First of all, the Red Cross nationally has a great mission statement. And we're going to show you that mission statement that you can see for yourself how direct it is, how clear it is in their delivery of their new mission statement for the Red Cross nationally. So let's talk about the American Red Cross, the mission statement. Janet, tell us about what key factors are about the statement.
It has been summarized to really go right to the heart of what we do. We prevent and alleviate human suffering in the face of emergencies by mobilizing the power of volunteers and the generosity of donors. And that's to the heart of it. We can't do what we do every day without those volunteers. One of the things we spoke about was that we operate on a ratio of 90 volunteers to each paid staff member. And that's how many of our paid staff members really have gotten engaged in it. They started out as volunteers.
There
are so many facets to Red Cross, so many different avenues of service that we provide. And frankly, we couldn't do that without people volunteering all the time. Things come and go. Some of the programs we offer, Meals on Wheels and Veterans Transportation, completely run almost exclusively on volunteer power.
Oh, absolutely. And it's all about the key, becoming a volunteer. So if you're thinking about, you know, you have some time in your hands, you might have been recently retired, or your schedule might have opened up with your work schedule, a little bit more free time, this is the place you really want to start with, because it's a great connection to the community. And we're going to show you some more information on how you can reach the Berks County chapter right here. We're going to show you the local phone number. We're going to show you the national number, as well as the website. So let's do that right now. If you need to contact the chapter house at 701 Center Avenue in the historical section of downtown Reading, you simply call 610-375-4383. The local number to the chapter house. They'd be glad to field any questions that you might have, how you can get connected or how you can get the services that are provided, how they can benefit you. By all means, call the Red Cross. You can also use the 1-800-RED-CROSS, as well as the www.redcross.org. These informations or contacts can get you where you need to go. We're going to talk about a hero breakfast coming up, which is a great event. And you can see Janet's email, janet.curtis@theredcross.org. Keep that as a reference, because that's her direct email that she can take questions or comments about what we're discussing tonight here on the Victory Show on BCTV. Let's talk about the big event coming up in May, the Heroes Breakfast.
What a huge and exciting and just emotionally moving event this is, Tom. Last year we had about 350 people who came together to honor the 9 recipients of our awards that we hand out every year. Some of the criteria for the awards, and we are still taking some nominations. If any of you out there have someone who may qualify for this, it was some type of heroic event that happened between January 1st, 2012 and December 31st, 2012. We have 9 different categories, and those are, if I may, military, please, EMS, fire, law enforcement, adult,
Good Samaritan,
youth Good Samaritan, I know I'm going to miss a couple.
Anything about the pets?
Animal rescue, community involvement, and I think that's all.
Right.
We hit them all.
So there is quite a few categories.
There are quite a few categories. It's really amazing to see the stories that come out. You know, you think it's Berks County, it's just a small area. Truly heroic deeds are being done every day, and we want to know about them.
Mm-hmm.
We need you to let us know. So please use those contact numbers and emails to call in, email in. We'll help fill out the nomination form, but we need those forms really in the next week because we are wrapping up those nominations. That information goes to a committee. Those are judged based on those categories, and we come out with our winners.
Wonderful. The event is scheduled for May 9th, and that will be held at the Crown. Right down over by Wyomissing.
Yes.
The prices of the tickets for those who want to come and participate and just be part of the ceremony.
It's $35. It's a breakfast. It starts at 7:30 in the morning. And there are table sponsorships and other sponsorships available. So if anyone's interested, again, give us a call.
About how long does the event usually run if someone's thinking about, I'd like to participate before I go to work?
And that's exactly why we have it at 7:30 in the morning. You can get there and be out. We wrap it up by 9 so that you can be on your way. But truly, you will leave there a different person than when you walked in if you haven't attended one of these.
Yeah, that's for sure. So there you have it. It's May 9th, coming up shortly. Call the Red Cross locally here at the Chapter House. Get the nomination forms. It's still not too late. About a 2-week window is still open. So if you know anybody that's in rescue services, disasters, that have worked diligently to help, please submit their nomination because they are well worth the spotlight of being recognized for their great good deeds that they do provide on their own initiative through volunteering. So May 9th at the Crown, it is going to be a spectacular event, 7:30 in the morning, and by 9 you can be on your way back to your busy work day. Let's talk about that's coming up also. In the event that some home viewers would like to get some health services classes and get really more training, that restructuring has taken place, and we're going to have Janet and both Kara talk about how that restructure has taken place to make it more convenient for you to do it more online at your own pace. So let's talk about health services with class training, how that can be obtained.
The first and best way to do that is you can call the 1-800 Red Cross. They can schedule you for a class that's already been set up. You can find one that's convenient to your location and your time. But if that doesn't work, we have online classes. It's called blended learning. So I have a family of 4, and that includes 2 teenagers. The idea that I can get the 4 of us together for an entire 8-hour class is almost non-existent, and I'm sure many of the viewers can relate to that. But at the same time, I'd like us to participate as a family and gain those skills that we can take with us for the rest of our lives. So the idea behind blended learning is that you can go online and register for a class and take part of the class, the book work, the learning part of it, online. And then when it's time for the practical, you'd all come together, set it up in a class, and do what's called a challenge. So you come in and just take those practical skills in front of an instructor, and you've completed your class and receive your certification.
And where would those challenges be located? Throughout the county?
Throughout the county. It varies. Again, it's one of those that is probably already set up. Mm-hmm. But once you've taken your information and background items off the internet, you can just get to a class that is more convenient for everyone involved in your group.
Perfect. And hopefully, once you become certified, that is just one step closer of becoming a volunteer, perhaps an instructor volunteer. Because once you become certified in the discipline area that you are, whether it be adult CPR, or whether it be first aid, or whether it even be pet first aid, they are always looking for volunteers to help teach these classes, and the structure has changed. You come in for the challenge, which is really a group session to show the practical aspects of how you can demonstrate the skills after you've completed the online portions of that. So there you have it. That's how you can help yourself through health services. It's kind of like at your own pace, you go to the website, which is the www.redcross.org. You can put in the zip code that you live in to get more information about classes that are being conducted, where you can go for your practical challenge aspects and get scheduled for that. That's a key aspect. And then we're also going to talk about a very important topic, which we always remind the people throughout the years, are you ready safe? Sometimes you really need to have your family in a structure where you have a go bag. We're going to talk about what the go bag is all about. And that, as a matter of fact, Kara, who is Disaster Services, has brought in a go bag to show you kind of a size that you would really need. Not a huge, medium size would be fine, but it's the contents of what you really want to pack in that. And we have a great story that Janet's going to share with us about her own family, in this particular case, her son. But let's go to Kara first to find out the go bag she's brought in and talk about some disaster services that are here in our community here in Berks County.
Thank you. Absolutely. Although we focus a lot on response, we also say if we did not have to respond, that would be wonderful. We love to get the preparedness information out there. And one of the main pushes in our region is preparedness and resiliency. So how does the community become more prepared, and how do we bounce back then quicker after a disaster, after something's happening? And one of the main pieces that we look at and that is prevalent that we deal with, and in fact we even saw today, are fires. We actually just responded to a fire today in the city, and unfortunately we see in certain areas, although we've been lucky, we see fatalities as well. We've seen up in Lackawanna County, up in Bradford County, some fatalities. So again, we really want to make sure the community is prepared and has the resources to know what to do, and if there is something to happen, what to have for that. And one of the great pieces that we really are pushing are these great tear sheets. And one of the pieces with the tear sheets, and in this one, this is a Be Red Cross Ready one, we have tear sheets in every sort of topic you can imagine. Fire safety, winter safety, thunderstorms, hurricanes.
Wow.
So it covers a wide range of everything. But this one in particular, which is what's so nice about it, it talks about getting a kit, making a plan, and being informed. So even on these sheets, it has what you should have in your together in a to-go kit, basically. Having 3 days supplies of water, having non-perishable food available. And these all can be found on redcross.org. One of the main pieces too is that we certainly at redcross.org you can certainly purchase these, but you can make your own, and that was one of the pieces that we really stress. That's why it's great to go on to see what you can, because a lot of these items are around your house already. You
right.
don't have to go out and purchase them. And you can put together a bag to be able to have. So if the power goes out, you know, and you have batteries, you have a flashlight, you have maybe tarp that you would need with duct tape, gloves to help clean up after a certain, like a storm, for example.
Right.
So there's all sorts of items that you can have that are very pertinent and great to be able to keep in your home.
Essential needs that people sometimes forget about.
Yes, definitely.
Well, we're going to talk more about that. We're going to go to a break at this time to tell you more about BCTV. Be informed, be involved.
You're watching The Victory Program on BCTV.org. Be informed, be involved. Be a member. For membership information, go to www.bctv.org/support/membership. For more information and other related stories, go to www.bctv.org. The Victory Program is underwritten by Chandler Lodge 227 of the Freemasons. Program underwriting is a valuable source of revenue for bctv.org and a way for you and your business to get exposure in the community. For more information on how you and your business can become program underwriters, go to www.bctv.org.
Hey, if you just tuned in, you're watching Victory here on BCTV. Be informed, be involved. I'm Tom Fack, your Victory host. This is the month of March, and this is also Red Cross Month. We have in tonight the studio, we have two very key elements of the staff members here, the local chapter. Janet and Kara have come in graciously to talk about the activities of Red Cross and what we've been discussing. We were just discussing prior to the break the go bag of disasters that would maybe occur in your own home or your neighborhood, and you have just minutes to evacuate. And let's talk about some of those stories that can happen and what you need to really reiterate of doing step by step. And more importantly, if you're thinking about becoming a disaster volunteer, we're going to talk about how you can do that. So tell us a story, Janet, about your family in regards to the go bag, because this is a neat story that connects everything together.
It is a great story. And the idea behind it is that my family has always been engaged because of my work, but also because I like to be prepared. It's just a habit, and my whole family has fallen into it. So it's a good thing. A couple years ago, when tornadoes were flowing through, I got a call that a tornado was headed toward my home.
Oh.
So being the good Red Cross director, I alerted my children who were with me immediately.
Good.
And it's a plane straight out. I said, there's a tornado coming, get down into the basement. With that, my daughter who was upstairs, my son was in the other room next to me. He ran upstairs.
He went up?
He went up. And my daughter had been taking a shower. She came out and had a towel and said, what's going on? I thought, this is not going well. This will be headlines tomorrow, the executive director of the Red Cross and her entire family. So
she didn't ask to see if she could dry her hair first.
No. So I reminded them again, tornado coming, we need to get down to the basement, get the dog, go down. My daughter went down. My son came barreling down the stairs two at a time, finally down into the basement, and I took care of a few mom things, and then I joined them. And as soon as I got down there, I thought, oh, my gosh. And I said it out. I said, I don't even have any water. I thought, this is not going well. This is not going well. And my son stopped, and he said, don't worry. He said, I'm prepared.
Great.
And he had his go bag.
So that's what he went upstairs for?
That's what he went upstairs for. He went upstairs for the go bag. I was impressed, I must say. The go bag had flashlight. It had a crank radio. It had gloves.
Wow.
It had rope. It had water. It had 20 pounds of canned goods. We discussed that later because that's where all my canned goods went. We talked about that. But the idea behind it was that he was prepared and he was self-assured. He had an aura about him that was so confident because he was prepared not just for himself but for his entire family. And if there's one thing I can get out to the viewers, it's that I can have the greatest plan in the world. Kara can have the greatest plan in the world. But if we don't share it with our families and we don't engage them in building this go kit or the
right.
go bag, it doesn't matter because we may be involved and engaged in the disaster as it's unfolding. They may be home, and if they don't know what to do or how to react, it won't go well. So he was, I guess, 12, 13 at the time.
Wow.
And he was ready, and it gave him just a better sense. How many times do things happen? If you're prepared yourself, not only is the response better, but you can also then help others. You can help your neighbors. You can help friends.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe that elderly person living down the street who may not have a go bag ready. It's easy to think of the circumstances that may cause us to evacuate our homes. A winter storm that knocks out the power for days. A hurricane that comes up and we're flooded. But rarely do we think of the times when it's something pressing and immediate, such as a hazardous material spill or a fire coming down the street, that you would need to grab those important elements that are better defined on redcross.org. You have those ready. At the very least, the medications you would need to take in the next 24 hours.
Oh, for sure.
Something for your pet.
We
work with CART teams in the counties now so that if you do need to evacuate to a shelter, you can take your pet with you.
And you need to have pet food.
Pet food, water, any medication, certainly a leash. If you have a crate container for them, that's always helpful too. We hope we never have to open a shelter. And if we do, we hope we don't have any residents in that shelter. But if we do, there are certain things that you can come up with and bring yourself. Toiletries, things that would make you more comfortable, again, in a situation that's out of your control.
Wow. Well, I tell you what, this leads us into the next segue. Your son, I hope, who is watching, Congratulations on the good doer that you are. And you are going to be a great candidate for a Disaster Volunteer Services. So let's talk about how you can become a volunteer with Disaster Services. Kara.
People can go to redcross.org and basically go through the application online. So it's an online application now, so it's a great opportunity. Makes it very simple, and then basically it comes to the chapter. So then we and the Emergency Services Department will go through and talk with the person and talk them through what it is to become a disaster action team member.
Right.
So you can be local, you can go and do national, you can do both if you want. With both those pieces, we do have training, and we have courses to know what to do, to be able to go out on the scene, how to do casework with clients, how to handle the situation. There's a lot of pieces with that, but we basically will pair new trainees with seasoned volunteers to be able to go out and learn and be able to be on the team, or in certain circumstances, we have specific specialties as well. So when people go out on to national disasters, they can do casework. If somebody's a nurse, they can do health services. If somebody's a licensed health mental health professional, they can go out in mental health.
Perfect.
So we have all different areas for all different sorts of people who want to get involved. Public affairs, logistics, those are great different specialty items, and certain people have that background. We have some people who've been in the military for long periods of time and come back and are great for logistics. But it may not even be a background. We've had people who have military backgrounds and want to do public affairs, which is great.
That'd be awesome.
And then again, translates back into our local, just being able to have a great cadre of volunteers. And again, we could not do this without them. They are the heart of what we do, and being able to go out and service the community. And we are always in need of new disaster volunteers.
Right. Is there a team always on standby at any given time?
There absolutely is. Our teams actually rotate through, and they are on, which is why we certainly appreciate what they do, because they're the ones that get up at 2 in the morning when it's raining, when it's snowing, and we'll go out and meet with the clients and all sorts of weather and times. But yes, we have volunteers that rotate through. We always, whenever we're called, we'll get a team together and send them out.
Now, every chapter house in the state does not necessarily have an emergency, you know, response vehicle, IRV, as it's known as, but here in Berks County, there is an IRV.
We have, a feeding vehicle that we're able to take out. We can distribute food and drinks out of there. People can come in. We can do casework out of it. So it's a great vehicle, and to be able to have in the county.
So the next time you see IRV, known to us as, in a parade site, certainly give a toot and a salute to all the people who are involved with that, because without IRV, things won't get done so fast at a response of a shelter or a disaster center. And if you're thinking about what can I do to donate, whether you want to donate goods, it's actually better just to donate money. Tell us about how easy that works if you just donate funds.
It's a great way. Again, you can go to redcross.org. You can actually call in as well. But it's one of the benefits of having funds donated and to the Disaster Relief Fund is because, again, although we appreciate all the goods that people want to donate to us, having to sort through them and go through them just isn't feasible for us. And a lot of times, depending on the situation and where the disaster is, being able to mobilize and get those goods into that area is sometimes impossible. And it also gives the people in that area the ability to use their local sources, resources, stimulate the economy and get that back up and going. So again, we appreciate the items that people want to donate. However, being able to donate actual money to the Disaster Relief Fund is really the best way to go.
Absolutely. Well, we appreciate all the efforts of everybody within the American Red Cross structure, but primarily we applaud all the volunteers. And become one yourself. We're going to show you at the end of this show how you can get the information if you missed it through tonight's broadcast, through the websites, the emails that we have also, but more importantly, the contact phone numbers. I wanted to thank both Janet and Kara for coming in on their busy schedule here to Studio A at BCTV and bringing the message to you, along with the mission statement, which I think is so key point right on. I just want to wish everyone a great, safe, and happy day, and how you can become involved with the Red Cross simply pick up the phone, or go to your web. I'm Tom Frank, wishing you all a victory day.
Victory is supported by Chandler Lodge 227 of the Free and Accepted Order of Masons.